Hello and welcome to our program. And today we are going to discuss about the current situation in Tripura as the Tripura Assembly elections are due next year. To discuss the issue, we have with us Comrade Jitendra Choudhary, who is a member of parliament from Tripura and is also associated with Adivasi Adhikar Manch. So welcome to our program.
Yeah, thank you.
So what is the situation in Tripura, being this IPFT is raising this entire issue of different state and they have created a blockade? What's the situation?
Actually, SS IPFT does not have that much of strength, and you know, during the recent time, the IPFT, they have conducted a road blockade program along with the blockade of the railway track also. Actually, that was totally designed by the BJP. Of course, initially that the demand for the Tripura land was raised by the IPFT first during the last autonomous district council election. And after that, in Tripura, the left forces, democratic organizations, they have initiated a very vigorous campaign politically and ideologically. The local body, the village committee election of the autonomous district council was held in Tripura. And there totally that IPFT, it was routed. Forthcoming election, BJP now, they are in the field. And they are trying to mobilize all these factions in the Congress, factions in the Trinamool Congress, factions in the other regional parties and the tribal organizations. While the NC Deborah faction of the IPFT only has been now raising this issue. All other tribal factions also not raising this issue now, because they understood in Tripura's geographical situation and its composition of the political, cultural and everything, it is hardly possible to create another state, and also by carving out the autonomous district council. It is also very unfortunate, not only the BJP, the Prime Minister office, they call the NC Deborah and some other leaders to Delhi, and from there itself, what the discussion they held, we don't know. Still, Prime Minister office also not given any statement. After coming out from the PMO, they informed the Tripura media that they are going to have the program in the month of June and July. Of course, June they have not done. In July 10th, they have started it. But there, what we have seen, what the Tripura people has witnessed, hardly 3,000 people initially, and afterwards it has come down. They assembled there and left front government with utter patience, and also to maintain the law and order and peace and harmony, they have was their program. But in no other places, in no other nook and corner of the state of Tripura, nothing, any kind of the solidarity or any kind of the people's support has been extended towards them.
So, Comrade, how is the BJP in Tripura trying to fish in the waters, because they have been trying to poach on various political parties? They don't have any base there, it looks like. How are they trying to create their own base? And
actually, BJP, of course, they are having some kind of the, in a different part of the country, they have their RSS organization in disguise. But openly in Tripura, before the BJP government, Modi government, came in the office, there was hardly any this visibility of the BJP there. Of course, there are the RSS activity here and there, and they have also the organizations, some institutions like the Banavasi Kalyan Samiti, like that. But political activity, etc., it was very, very poor. Now, after the Modi came in the power, so definitely some sort of the enthusiasm has been created. And other hand, the main opponent in our state is the Congress. That Congress, because of the inaction, because of their isolation throughout the country, in the state of Tripura, whatever they have their support base, they were suffering from the utter frustration. So BJP slowly targeted these people, and initially they have borrowed, they have purchased some of their leaders. This Congress also not directly came to the BJP. First they joined in Trinamool Congress, then now switching over to the BJP. And not only among the Congress, they have also the same kind of the emphasis to forgive the other leaders from the tribal factions. Among the tribal factions, there are not only the IPFT Narendra Chandra Deburma group, there are IPFT Budhu Deburma group also, there are INPT, there are NCT and some other factions. So BJP, by the means of their money power, they are forging in these factions, their leaders in particular, in one hand. Secondly, the very unusual amount of the vulgar, like the abusing against the individual, against the left-front government, and all false propaganda about the Modi government, and they are alluring the people that if Modi government comes, there will be job in every home. In other states where BJP is in the power, nothing there in a position to visualize before the people that this we are doing in other states, because the left front government during last more than 24.5 years, the left is in the power there. In every aspects of the people's life, right from the very poor people who lives in the villages, even in the cities, for the tribals, for the SCs, for the religious minorities, the left-front government, through the route of their own programs and also by successfully implementing all the central sponsored schemes, they are in the state of Tripura in all other aspects. And if you go by the socio-economic, any kind of indicators, you will find Tripura is doing very, very well and much, much ahead of the any other states. So that's why BJP activists or their leaders who are visiting BJP, they have depended upon the three-pronged strategy. One is alluring the people with the assurance of giving job, giving all individual benefits. Secondly, abusing against the left. And third, the launching the campaign against the left-hand government. In other hand, by forging in all these political elements.
So they are actually trying to create regional divide as well.
Yes.
So are they also trying to pitch in like the communal divide that they have been trying to push in the entire country?
Of course, ultimately it will lead to the communal divide. Tripura lamps mean what? That a state has to be carved out from these tiny states, and purely for the tribal there will be a state. If according to their demand, if there one another state to be created, carved out, what will happen? The rest part of Tripura will be divided in the 7 islands. Tripura's area and size is only 10,449 square kilometer. So if you carved out it again and the rest part become the 7 islands, how come that can be governed? how come that part of the land that the people who are inhabiting in those segments, their life, their economy, how that can be maintained? So this is clearly that will lead to a communal divide. They will lead to a like a civil war like, which is not welcome by any right thinking people, any peace loving people, or not only of the Tripura, anyone outside Tripura also, they can't imagine like this.
So you have pointed out left front government in Tripura has lot of achievements in its name.
Yeah.
MGNREGA, the literacy rate, the human indicator, and also repeal of APSPA.
Yeah.
Would you like to throw some light on that, and how does the left front aim to tackle these tendencies?
For more than three decades, this same Congress party who are in the center, they rule the state of Tripura. And during their period, the tribals who were during the feudal regime very much in the pitiable condition, further they are exploited by the Congress, not only the tribals, both the refugee Bengalis. And there the left front government came in 1978 under the leadership of our legendary leader, Comrade Nipin Chakraborty and the Saradev. And under the leadership of the left front government, the land reforms came, universal education came, people had the access of the people's program, and that has slowly that the people's their livelihood has been enhanced, literacy has been achieved, and both the tribals who have totally been marginalized, you know, once upon a time, slowly they also got the lease of life, and the Bengali, the refugee people, they got also rehabilitated, and that way some kind of the equilibrium, some kind of the balance have been established. And not only that, the left front government, its promise before the left front government installed in 1978, that the autonomous district council under the provision of 6th schedule of the constitution, it was that provision was not for Tripura earlier. The Tripura's democratic people under the leadership of the left front government and left front fought relentlessly for that, and the then central government under the leadership of the Indira Gandhi, she has been compelled to
acknowledge
it, and by amending the constitution of India, the Tripura has been included in the sixth schedule. And the sixth rural area, and its main focus or objective is that the tribal area which have been earmarked, there should not be any further alienation of land, tribal land to the non-tribals. So that way, that ADC area has been totally protected, the land has been protected to the hands of the tribal till today, very sanctitily it is being maintained. Then the recognition of the Kanwars, that has been recognized as one of the official languages of the Tripura. First time ever the left front government has given them the recognition, their land has been protected, culture has been recognized, language recognized. That way the development, it has started. And the difference between the other part of the country and difference between the tribals of the other region of the country and Tripura, now very easily it can be compared.
So what's the preparation that the left front has for the upcoming elections, and how will the left front tackle these forces?
No, you see, the Tripura's left front, it is not the new experience for us. Even while the Congress was the main opponent, the Congress party also has always depended upon the subversive forces, extremists like Tribal National Volunteer, ATPLU, All Tripura Tiger Force and NLFT. It is all backed and created by all this bourgeois party. So now this BJP, it is also another bourgeois party. Their design may be something different to the Congress, but they are also same way they are going by hiring all these, sectarian forces. In Tripura left front is always more than 50%, and during last 2013, it is about 53%. So this time also, left is preparing only by ensuring and by cementing that forces of the trust. And during last 5 years, what the achievements the left front government made in the state of Tripura in infrastructural development, in successful program in the education, health and rural development, etcetera, encashing upon them and throw this positive support or positive vote of the people, left government, left front is the again preparing its election campaign for next 2018.
Thanks a lot for giving us your time, and as these things proceed, we'll be coming back to you and such. Thanks a lot. Thank you for watching our program.